This may have seemed like a boring iPhone update year, and it sort of was. But that's okay. It's totally not sustainable to expect a major design refresh every year. Despite how green Apple claims to be, the only thing that does is create more waste. Even though there weren't big changes, there were plenty of interesting changes that we found in our teardowns. In this video, I'll walk you through 5 of those changes with a little help from our livestream and our written teardowns, which we'll link below. First up in our countdown, number 5, cool cameras. The new cameras in the Pro iPhones are almost unbelievable. Just look at the difference in size between the 12 Pro and the 13 Pro camera modules. It's wild that they were able to make this much room in the non-max body. Cameras are quickly becoming my favorite part of smartphones, not necessarily because I like to take pictures with them, but because they're so intricate and interesting to take apart. I'll show you what I mean. Here's an iPhone 13 Pro camera assembly fresh out of an iPhone. Behind the metal housing, you can already see some of the tiny image stabilization hardware. Usually, a bunch of heat lets me pull the whole standard wide unit out, but today, just the sensor wanted to come off, so we can get straight to the good stuff. In their keynote last year, Apple showed off the iPhone 12 Pro Max with sensor shift image stabilization. This is an all-new sensor and lens, but the stabilization hardware is pretty similar. It will subtly move the sensor around up to 5,000 times per second to counteract your shaky hands. The smaller 12 Pro Max sensor on the left now lives in the mini and standard iPhone 13s. I was hoping to put this lensless sensor back in the phone to show you how it moves around. I even poked a hole in the glass so you could see it better, but unfortunately neither of the cameras that I disassembled survived, so maybe next year. Number 4, some new display tech. Apple announced one major change to the iPhone 13 Pro displays on stage with ProMotion, but we found another upgrade they didn't mention. All 4 iPhones this year are using new OLED technology with an integrated touch layer. Our friend Tobias from Instrumental explains it on our live stream.
So taking a look at the iPhone 13 Pro display, which again, like Taylor mentioned, has this new ProMotion display panel, a completely redesigned OLED. And when we compare it with the 12 Pro, it has 2 cables coming off, 2 flex cables coming off of that display, with the 2 board-to-board connectors that plug in. But the new 13 Pro just has 1 cable. In the old model, the iPhone 12, so there's actually 2 separate flex cables because under the hood here, there is a touch panel, which is just a super thin, transparent plastic layer that's between the display and the glass. And what it looks like they were able to do on the 13 is combine that touch layer in with the display.
If only they didn't pair this screen to the logic board. More on that in a minute. Number 3, return of the L-shaped battery. For a few years now, Apple has been using some pretty cool tech to take advantage of the extra space around their super dense stacked logic boards. We found a couple patents that show just how they accomplished this. Carefully layered electrodes, and a clever notch on the inward corner. The 12 Pro battery last year shared the regular 12's rectangular shape, which was great for parts compatibility, again, if the things weren't paired. This year, it makes a return to the 13 Pro, more powerful than the 12, but less so than the rectangular 13. That's right, even though it looks bigger and takes up more space, it's not quite as potent as the good old rectangle. Number 2. The shrinking of Face ID. While everyone else has moved on to hole punches, Apple has been pretty content with their signature notch for the last few years. This year on stage, they announced the iPhone 13 notches were 20% smaller. What did Apple do with that extra screen space? Not a single thing. The redesigned Face ID module on the inside is interesting though. To accomplish this nothing, they took the infrared flood illuminator off the display and integrated it with the rest of the Face ID hardware. Now all the infrared flashy lights come from the same spot in the notch. And finally, we've arrived at number 1, parts pairing absurdity. Well, we saved the worst for last. Believe it or not, the iPhones 13 are still victims of Apple's attempt to monopolize their repair. In our livestream, we were able to perform a battery swap, which felt like a win, since some rumors were claiming an iPhone 13 wouldn't even turn on with a foreign battery installed. But that small victory didn't last very long. After a long day of extensive testing, we and some others found that despite the simple new display replacement procedure, any display swap we performed, even transferring the original Face ID hardware, would disable Face ID completely. I will say this behavior feels buggy, and it's possible that Apple could fix this with software like we saw last year, where camera swaps between iPhone 12s would cause the camera to glitch out until a later software update. But even if Face ID worked flawlessly after a DIY display swap, you're still losing other important features like True Tone and Auto Brightness. Add to that the fact that you have to deal with annoying warnings and constant reminders from the settings app, and you've got a downright awful repair experience. Apple has reasons for parts pairing and safety pop-ups, and some of them are even valid. But don't you for one second believe that they couldn't find another way around this problem if they wanted to. This is the same company that makes a $30,000 user serviceable cheese grater, you know? That thing doesn't give you any warnings when you swap a part, believe me. Okay, rant over. For a more comprehensive look at all the ways parts pairing affects iPhones 13, you can check out Hugh Jeffrey's video, which we'll link below. We should have our own blog coming soon with all of our parts testing results. Oh, and one last fun but unhelpful thing we found in our parts testing. It's not pretty, but if you really want to, you can put an iPhone 13 Pro Max screen on an iPhone 13 Pro and vice versa. You're welcome, Software Gore subreddit. No matter how cool you think the new iPhone 13s are, we can't say it enough, don't upgrade unless you need to. These phones are just fine, but the best phone is the one you already have. Oh, if you haven't had a chance, you can click here to watch the livestream of our iPhone 13 and 13 Pro teardown. Thanks for watching.